Picture this, going to sleep the night before Christmas, to wake up the next morning to see all of the presents that Santa left you. Or putting your tooth under the pillow, to wake up the next morning to find a dollar bill. Or how about seeing all of the candy left in your baskets on Easter? Believing in fictional characters gives children a sense of magic and creativity. How many of you guys believed in some of these characters as a kid? I think that you should let them believe, and I hope to persuade you to do the same. Why is this relevant for us? Well, we are all coming to the age where someday we're going to be parents. We're going to have kids that are probably going to want to celebrate some of these traditions. Everyone who has believed in these characters has great stories to tell. However, many parents nowadays are not allowing their children to believe in these characters. I will provide information, problems, and solutions about believing in these characters. Let's talk about who some of them are. Santa Claus, the man everybody knows and loves. Where did he originate? He's formerly known as Saint Nick, and he's been around since 280 AD. He gave all of his inherited wealth to those in need. Mall Santas came around in 1820 to help advertise for stores and also allow children to celebrate Christmas. Next, we have the Tooth Fairy. Unfortunately, I could not find any origin that the Tooth Fairy was from, and all I know is that dentists have been using this technique for a very long time to get kids to brush their teeth. The Easter Bunny. It's been around since the 1700s when German immigrants came over into Pennsylvania. Many of the children would lay nests out in the grass and hope that this Easter Bunny would come and lay special colored eggs. So why do some parents not want their children to believe? A lot of parents use these characters as a listening technique. However, some use it to make holidays better. But why are so many against it? Parents teach their children not to lie, and some view this as a form of lying to their children. In an article written by Sophie Heiser, she interviewed educational and developmental psychologist Kelly Allen. Kelly states, people who engage in rituals around Santa and Christmas are literally memory-making with their children. They're marking distinct occasions and time to be remembered in the future in a way that helps family traditions and shared social experiences. So let's talk about some solutions. If you believe that this is a form of lying to your children, there are other ways around it. You can tell them that you've heard myths or stories about these characters. So technically, you're not telling them that they're real. This does allow the children to decide whether or not they want to believe that it's real. Next, let's talk about some benefits. We can still have fun as adults with this. I know I was a very strong believer in all of these characters. Now that we're old enough, we're able to help our parents with some of our younger siblings pass on these traditions. Or, like I said earlier, we will become parents one day and start our own traditions. Personal stories that I have was growing up, if I lost a tooth at my grandma's house, I would wake up the next morning to find a dollar bill that had glitter all over it. It was only at her house and I wasn't sure why, but I did like that. Another was carrots on the front porch. The night before Christmas, we'd toss them out on the front porch. Next morning we'd wake up to find these baby carrots had been bitten in two and also glitter on the front porch. That was not my grandma's doing. Next was filling the Easter baskets. We'd put them on the edge of our bed, by the end of it, and the next morning we'd wake up to see that there were loads of candy all over. It's never too late to make your own memories and beliefs come true. This, by celebrating some of these traditions, it brings family closer. It gives kids hope and also a memorable childhood. These traditions are a good thing. Some parents don't want to lie, and that's okay. There are ways around it. But the memories will last a lifetime. I've hoped to share enough information and benefits about believing in these fictional characters. And kids only get one childhood. So what's wrong with a little magic?